Okay, we got a game against Hippo. He's using the Skarm Chansey defensive core. But let's see how we are going to break through this. It's always difficult to play against a Skarmory with a Joyous Bandit Guard Jump, and he also has an Azumarill, which is a fairy type. So I don't see Guard Jump doing anything early in the game. We just need to get rid of the Skarmory first. He leads off with Gliscor. I'm just going to try to set up my Stealth Rocks as he reveals Knockoff. And he doesn't go for Taunt. Now I'm just going to go for the Pain Split just to get a bit of recovery. And I kind of want to see what he does. He goes for Earthquake. So he has Knockoff and he has Earthquake. But at least I'm pretty sure he won't go for Knockoff again. So I'm going into my Zapdos. Let's see. What will you do, my friend? He goes for Ice Fang. So knock off Earthquake and Ice Fang. So he has three attacks. This last attack, Roost. Anyway, I'm going for Hidden Power Ice. He is the defogger, or Skarmory is the defogger. One of the two has to be the defogger. Let's see. He stays in. Goes for defog. But now Gliscor is really low. I'm still gonna go for Hidden Power Ice because I just want to force this Gliscor out so that it cannot switch in anymore. But he does bring in a Chansey. And perhaps Chansey is his Stealth Rocker and Skarmory his Spike user. So I am gonna go into... Wait, let's actually go into Muk here so that I can get off a knockoff. Let's go for Seismic Dose. It does get some damage off of my Muk, but that's fine. As long as I keep my Muk a bit healthy for Alakazam. But I'm gonna go for Knockoff now. Let's see. He shows Protect on Chansey, so... A lot of strange things happening. Now I'm gonna go for the Pursuit, because I know he's going to switch out. Pretty sure you don't want to tank a Knockoff. But it does switch out. And we get a crit. But even for a crit, that did nothing to Chansey. Holy shit. Yes, Skarmory is coming in, and at this point I'll just go into my fortress. But if he does go for his Stealth Rocks, I can just rapid spin them away. Okay, he does go for rocks. So Gliscor the defogger, Skarmory the Stealth Rocker. Chansey would protect. So anyway, he goes back into his Chansey. That's fine. We got up our rocks, and now I'm just gonna rapid spin them away. Because I can Pain Split if he goes for Seismic Dose. Let's actually go for Pain Split right now. In case he does go for Seismic Dose, trying to kill my fortress. As he brings in the Gliscor, and this is actually really bad because I just healed his Gliscor. Let's see, what are we gonna do? Let's just Pain Split again. Or I can switch into Starmie now, expecting him to defog. He's not pressing knockoff on my fortress there. So he does go for defog, and I'm gonna press trick now. Because I need to make something happen. I need to make something happen, so I think his Chansey is gonna come in. So I get the choice packs on his Chansey, which is the first step on breaking his defensive core. Now I go back into Fortress. As he goes for Seismic Dose. Let's bring in the Clefable here. Because he's locked into Seismic Dose, so I can go for Wish with Clefable. And then I'll be able to wish pass to something like Fortress, perhaps. If he switches out. He actually goes straight into Nidoking. But that's fine. Because now I can go into Starmie. Starmie won't die to Sludge Wave. Starmie should be living the Sludge Wave. goes for flamethrower. The Starmie easily takes that. I get my Starmie back at full HP. And now I get to press Psyshock. Because only thing that on his team that resists Psyshock is his Skarmory. But then I will break his sturdy and I can go for Surf afterwards. He does go into Chansey. So I get the analytic boost. And that's a nice amount of damage off on Star on his Chansey. I could switch, but I think I'd prefer to go for Psyshock here. Because he will most likely go for the healing move. For Seismic Dose. What am I talking about? I can just Psyshock again, and yeah, nothing is gonna switch into this. Because if he brings in Skarmory, I get a free Surf off on his team. And that Surf will be analytic if he switches out. So Chansey goes down. Do not have to worry about that thing anymore. So the next step should be getting rid of the Skarmory. He goes into Azumarill. And at this point, I might as well sack my Fortress. Because if he goes for Belly Drum, I still have my Clefable healthy. And if he goes for an attack, then he might be Choice Bandit. So we are basically gonna find it out right now. But second Fortress here is my play, I think. Yeah, I really think this is my play. Because Clefable gets 2-hit KO'd by Bandit. Okay, he doesn't knock us out, he goes for Belly Drum. And now we basically go into our Clefable, because you usually don't run Waterfall on Belly Drum Azumarill. The set is usually Aqua Jet, Play Rough, and Knock Off. So he does go for Aqua Jet, and I did nothing, so he should know that I'm unaware Clef, but I'm gonna go for the Protect here. Because if he switches out, he just wasted his Citrus Berry. And now I will go for the Wish. All I need to do is force this Azumarill to switch out. And now we go for the Protect in case he crits us. And we should be good. He does stay in, so he doesn't bring in his Nidoking. Now I might as well go for Moonblast. Okay, nice. We got this Moonblast damage off, so this Azumarill can never Belly Drum up again. And now I'll just press Protect again. As he goes for Play Rough. And at this point, there's nothing this Azumarill can do. Here we go for Wish. He goes for Play Rough again. And now we can press Protect. He's most likely gonna expect to Protect and switch into Nidoking, but it's fine. Because now I can double Protect. Goes for Sludge Wave, and at this point I can just sack my Fortress and get a kill with Starmie, pressing Surf. Yeah, as long as the Skarmory is alive, my Garchomp can't really do anything, especially with Azumarill being there to tank the Fire Fang as well. So we have to think for something for that. Yeah, I'll be able to bring a Starmie. Could be funny if this guy has Sucker Punch. But he already showed Flamethrower and Ice Beam, but he won't have Sucker Punch. I can just go for Surf here, and something will die, because Azumarill will get 2-hit KO'd as he brings in the Gliscor. So Gliscor is gone. And now he has to bring in his Alakazam, which is the only thing that outspeeds me. I'll just go into my Clefable here. Because perhaps he predicts my Muk to come in and go for Focus Blast. Goes for Energy Ball. And I can just go for the Wish here. And there's nothing stopping me from wishing up here. He goes for Psy Shock. And now I can just press Protect. Because if he has Calm Mind, I'm just gonna set up Calm Mind myself. He brings in the Nidoking again. And I'm just gonna protect again, just to keep my Clefable healthy. And now, let's bring in the Zapdos. Zapdos is the most expendable member right now, because my Starmie can still knock out the Skarmory. I'll just go for Hidden Power Ice. Let's roost first before this, and then we'll go for Hidden Power Ice. Just wanted to see what he would do. Perhaps he had Ice Beam. Perhaps he would have used Ice Beam. Yeah. I'm just gonna hit up our Ice now, as he does go for Ice Beam right now. And now Nidoking is also in range of Dragon Claw. But we'll bring in our Starmie again. And claim another kill. Because if he sacks Azumarill, and then I can press use Fire Fang with Garchomp, and if he sacks Skarmory, I get to press Earthquake with Garchomp. Basically, opening up a room, an opportunity for my Garchomp. But he decides to bring in his Skarmory, and this Skarmory will obviously get to it KO'd. And now he has no ground immunity anymore, so I'm able to bring in my Garchomp later on and press Earthquake. Now Alakazam comes in. I'm pretty sure I should live to Focus Blast from the amount of health that I'm currently at, because I still have my Assault Vest up. I'm bringing in my Muk. As he goes for Energy Ball, that's fine. Now we get to press Pursuit, and whether he switches or stays in, he will die. And Muk basically doing his job for this game. He goes for Focus Blast, he gets a crit, doesn't knock me out, and I knock out the Alakazam with Pursuit. And his remaining Pokemon will die to my Garchomp. So we basically set up everything for our Garchomp to clean up the game. And that's usually how this team works. I haven't used Garchomp in this whole game yet, but now it comes in and it will win me the game. Obviously, I can also win with Starmie now, but for the sake of the video, we are going to win with Garchomp spamming Earthquake at the end. Yes, we set it up really nicely for Garchomp. Azumarill goes down. And Nidoking will obviously go down to Earthquake as well. And that is pretty much the game, guys. So yeah, dealing with Skarmory and a Fairy type does take some time to get through when you're using Choice Banded Garchomp, but we build it off, and I see you guys in the next game. Okay guys, we got a game against Atomic Cat. Atomic Cat with the Snorlax costume. And a Snorlax on his team, so you gotta feel your Pokemon, right? I'm just gonna lead up with Fortress, trying to get on my Stealth Rocks as he leads off with Mew. I'm still going for Stealth Rocks, even though Mew can carry Taunt. But if he shows Taunt, then I pretty much know the moveset, because he will most likely have Roost and Will-O-Wisp. So his last move will either be Defog or Ice Beam, perhaps. Yeah, now I'm just gonna bring in my Muk. I don't care if my Muk gets burnt. I just want to be able to knock off this Mew's item. As he misses the Will-O-Wisp, so that is great for me. That means he's most likely gonna stay in again. As he misses again, so that is really unfortunate for Atomic Cat. I get a lot of damage off on this Mew, and now I'm just gonna stay in and spam Poison Jab till I poison this thing. He does connect finally, and I do not poison him, unfortunately. The reason I went for Poison Jab there anyway was because he might have would have gone for Roost there. But yeah, I'll Poison Jab again as we still do not poison him, and we're gonna keep trying. Because if he switches right now, he will be at 50%, which means my Garchomp will easily kill it. As he brings in Hippowdon, so I hope we poison this thing, because that would be very awesome, guys. Okay, we do poison the Hippowdon, and that means that Hippowdon cannot reliably switch into my Garchomp anymore. But now I'm going into Fortress. I can Rapid Spin and Stealth Rocks away, or I can actually get up my own Stealth Rocks. Because he might go into Mug now. He might go into his Mew now, and if I go for Rapid Spin, he can taunt me afterwards. I'd rather go for Stealth Rocks, and if he does go Mew, I can still Rapid Spin. As he actually brings in Snorlax, so we do really not care about this Snorlax at all, guys. My unaware Clefable is waiting for it, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm going for Rapid Spin. Get rid of his Stealth Rocks. As he does go for Curse. And we'll bring in our Clefable. The Sandstorm will subside the next turn. So he won't even know that I'm unaware yet. I can set up a Calm Mind. And the moment he attacks me, he will find out that I'm unaware. Goes for Body Slam. And he should know that I'm unaware now. I'm just gonna Calm Mind again, because I want to force this Mug to come in. As he does bring in the Mug, so Mug takes Stealth Rocks damage. And I pretty much want to get all the damage on Mug that I can, so that my Staryu can do a lot in this game later. So now we're going into Fortress, because Fortress doesn't really have to tank any physical attackers on his team, so I might as well bring it in against the Mug. And the chance that he goes for a poison move is really great, as he does go for Poison Jab. And yeah, we have our Stealth Rocks up. We removed his Stealth Rocks. I think it's time to use Explosion. And after this Explosion, this Mug will not be able to switch into my Starmie anymore. So he goes for Fire Punch. That should not knock me out. I have Sturdy, but he burns me, and that burn is unfortunate, because I would have done around 60% if he didn't burn me, which means he wouldn't have been able to come in against my Starmie anymore, which I'm bringing in my Garchomp. We still get a kill because we can bring it in freely, and nothing on his team is going to switch into this Earthquake. But yeah, that was basically the idea of the Explosion, allowing my Garchomp to come in safely. Because I could have hard switched into my Garchomp, but then there was also the chance that he might get the Poison Touch off, and I do not want my Garchomp poisoned. But yeah, now my opponent has to let something die, and this is the most interesting part of the game, I think. Because let's see what my opponent will sack. Because Mew is at around 50%, and Mew can never switch into a Choice Bandit Garchomp. As he will get 2 hit KO'd anyway. Hippowdon is poisoned, and Stealth Rocks are up, so he will also get 2 hit KO'd. Starmie will get 1 hit KO'd. And Azumarill will get 1 hit KO'd as well after Stealth Rocks, as he decides to bring a Mew. And Mew straight up dies after the crit, putting him 6 feet under. That crit did not matter, guys, but it's all about asserting dominance, guys. All about asserting dominance. Now he brings in his Starmie, and I'm just gonna bring in my Mug, because he might go for Ice Beam here, because he should know that Hydro Pump is not knocking me out, especially because he doesn't get the analytic boost. Goes for Ice Beam. It doesn't do a lot, even after the crit. Okay, it goes for a Rapid Spin. We saw Leftover, so I went for Knockoff instead of Pursuit. This might be a bulky Starmie, but yeah, I'm going for Poison Jab here, trying to poison this guy. After I poison this guy, I will spam pursuit. As he actually stays in and goes for Scald. And we get the poison touch off. And he will die to poison, so that is great. And now... now I don't need my muck anymore. But I think I want to stack my muck on the Azumarill later on. Because he brings in his Hippowdon. And... I'll just go straight into Starmie because he might go for Stealth Rocks here. Knowing that my muck cannot do anything against his Hippowdon anyway. And even if he goes for Earthquake, my Starmie should be able to take it. So he does go for Rocks, and what we are going to do now is we are going to double into our Garchomp in case he does bring in his muck or his Snorlax. The Snorlax can also easily take the surf damage. So my opponent does bring in the muck, bring in the Snorlax. And now he will definitely get to hit KO'd by Earthquake. Even if, because my Earthquake should do about 60% to this guy. So if he curses, then my next Earthquake will do around 40%. So it should be a 2-hit KO here. Let's go for curse, and the leftovers recovery doesn't matter because the sandstorm is up. So he gets pretty much screwed by his own sandstorm, and we knock out the Snorlax. So Choice Bandit Garchomp putting in work right here. Now Azumarill comes in, and I might not be able to knock it out because Azumarill has a lot of HP. I'm going into Muk. If he's Belly Drum, it doesn't matter because my Clefable is still healthy. And I don't need Muk anyway, so let's see what he does. Does go for Play Rough, so I think it's Choice Bandit. Unfortunately, the Sandstorm subsided. So after the Sandstorm damage, he would have most likely been in range of Choice Bandit Earthquake. But now I'm bringing in my Zapdos, guys. And we're just gonna press Thunderbolt here. Because even if he brings in Hippowdon, I'll just go hard into Starmie. Because his Hippowdon cannot knock out my my Starmie. So he does go into Hippowdon, and let's see. Let's actually go for Hidden Power Ice here, because I want to force him to slack off. Goes for Toxic, so... Now Hippowdon is forced to go for Slack Off, so I can safely bring in my Pokemon, being Starmie. And I don't think Muk will be able to switch into the Surf. So he either has to sack something and then bring in Muk. Because if he brings in Muk, now he will... My Surf is analytic boosted, and he will also take the Sandstorm damage. So yeah, this is definitely a 2-hit KO. And we go for Surf again. And Muk goes down, so the Explosion damage still was important on this Muk. Explosion pretty much allowed me to get damage on Muk and give me a free kill with Garchomp. Now, I'm just gonna sack Clefable. Because we know he's Choice Bandit. He knocks out my Clefable, and I'll just bring in Garchomp, press Earthquake. Hippowdon cannot come into this. And even if I don't knock it out, I can knock it out with Surf afterwards. So that should pretty much be the game. I'll just press Earthquake here. As he actually switches. And he actually gives me a free Sandfall boost. Because now Hippowdon will just die. He will get 2-hit KO'd. Look, 55% damage, guys. So Hippowdon goes down. And remember, you give me the Sandfall boost, so I might be able to dodge the Play Rough, because Play Rough doesn't have 100% accuracy on itself, and the Sandfall also reducing the chance to hit. So let's see. Let's go for Play Rough, and he misses. His own Sandstorm really fucked him up in this game. Because of the Sandstorm, I got the damage that I needed on Snorlax. Basically, countering his leftovers recovery. But yeah, that was the game. So thank you for watching.